Hello, welcome over to the backdrop of my videos. Normally, this is kind of my vintage area. No, I don't actually use this stuff. I use modern equipment. So this stuff is basically just for decoration. But I have played around with it to see what it was like back in the day, because that's mild curiosity, if you will, of mine. But today we're going to be taking a look at a program that George R.R. Martin, the author of A Game of Thrones, A Song of Ice and Fire, has admitted to using. I saw a lot of people on the videos where he admits this and the blog articles wondering if using such antiquated technology is the reason for how slow everything is. So you'll be able to judge for yourself pretty soon if using this would make you a slower writer in general. Now, I am not using a vintage DOS computer, which is what George R. R. Martin uses. He writes on a program called Wordstar 4, and it ran on MS-DOS, which was a disk-based operating system that was the precursor to Windows. Now, as you'll see in a second, if you're not familiar with DOS, it is not at all similar to Windows. It is a text-based instead of graphic-based. So it's quite a bit different, and I was trained on it when I was like 5 years old in elementary school, but I had completely forgotten how to use it, so I had to relearn it. It's not very difficult, however. But yeah, my machine is not an actual DOS machine. And actually, what you see is quite misleading. On the bottom, you have a Texas Instrument computer, which, yes, it's the same people who make your graphing calculators. And it's from the 70s, 80s, and basically, it's completely useless. It has some very, very basic functions on it. And I do have a word processing program for it, but it sucks. And you can't save anything because this is older than floppy disks. How you saved on this computer was with a cassette deck. Yes, cassette tapes that you play music on. So we're not going to be using this, but we are going to be using the beautiful monochrome green phosphorescent display, which is actually from an Apple II, and Apple IIs did not run DOS. What this is hooked up to right now is a modern laptop I use every day. And it's running an emulator of DOS, but it will be exactly the same as DOS. So I'm not going to be using this keyboard, so don't be confused by that. But let's get started. All right, so here we are with beautiful MS-DOS. Now, as you can see, no pointers or anything. So if you've never seen a text-based operating system before, welcome back to what they told me when I was 5 years old was what you really had to know. So that says a lot about the education system when they tell you things you'll really need to know. Basic of DOS, I'm not going to really go into it that much because this isn't about DOS. Basic text commands, you type DIR and that shows you all your menus. And this is really nasty looking because this is an emulator. And there's a lot of unpacked files in there. But what we are concerned about is Wordstar 4, which you might be able to see down there at the bottom as WS4. So to go there, we're going to type CD for change directory and WS4, enter. Now you can see we are in the C/WS4 directory. So we can type DIR again to see what's all in here. But basically we are in here, so all we need to type is WS, and that will load the program. So here we are in Wordstar. Welcome. Isn't it beautiful? Look at it. It looks a little confusing, I guess, at first. But it's really pretty simple. Down there at the bottom, it says directory, and it shows you the files. And so you can see a couple of the things that I was playing around with. So to open a document, you would just type D, and then you would type which one you wanted to load. So there it goes. But we are going to back out of this and open a new file, because it's what that we want to start something new. So to do that, we'll just press D again, and then we're going to type, I don't know, Wordstar demo. And it says, can't find that file, create a new one, and I'll just hit Y for yes. Okay, so here we are. This is Wordstar, once again, without the text that I have typed in before. So, what exactly is going on? Well, it's pretty simple to just start typing. There isn't really anything complicated about that. And so it's going to function just like any word processing program in the sense that you can just immediately type. So this is a fully functioning word processing program as you know it, in the sense of being able to format your text. You can center it justify it, left align, right align, bold, italicized. However, it does not have any spell check or grammar check, which is something that George R. R. Martin mentioned that he liked about this program. When he types something, it stays that way. He doesn't have to battle with the machine trying to either tell him it's wrong or auto-changing it for him. So that's probably one of the key reasons that he sticks with this, beyond the fact that he just knows this program. Okay, so this up here is your cheat menu. It's for people like me and anybody else who's just started using the program and they don't know all of the shortcuts. In the same sense, the Microsoft Word has your control, you know, V, control C, control E, control J. You probably know what all of those things do because you've been using it for so long. This program has basically the same thing as far as control, and then you hit a letter and it does something. It's not at all the same as Microsoft Word, however, so I have to leave it up when I'm doing things like that still. But once you're comfortable with it, you can make it disappear. So to do that, you just hit F1, then you'll hit F1 again, and then you can hit 0, and boom, it's all gone, just completely gone. So then you'll be able to type without all that junk in the way. Is that a Y? Yeah. Looks like a G from back here. Okay, but let's focus on aligning things for a moment. Let's put one more sentence in here. Whoops, spelled sentence wrong. In here for the giggles. Okay, so we're gonna have to turn this stuff back on so that I can see what to do. So if you look up here in the menus, specifically right there, you can make it go to on-screen format, so that'll really help me. And that is a control B? No. Control 0? Control O? Okay, so control O. Then we can set the margins, turn word wrap on and off, turn right justify off, which is your right side, and you make it a nice pretty line. So let's center a line. So we're going to hit C, and there you go. The line will be centered. So if you wanted to make your title, you just have to be on the line and then hit C after you hit Control O, mind you. So we're going to set that one back. I wonder if I can I just hit C again? No. All right. It's a different program. Once you get used to it, I'd imagine it'd be just second nature than the way that Microsoft Word is for most of us. Ah. So if you want to uncenter it, you just delete the spaces that it put before it. Okay, that's interesting. Okay. But now you'll see that it's not at all lined up all pretty like, and it needs to be pretty. It turned it back the second I started typing. Okay, so we got it all aligned again, pretty like. So what else would we want to do? Bold? Let's try bolding something. Okay, to bold something, we're just going to hit, you can see down here, this is another cheat menu. F4 is for bold. Or you can type caret B. And this is bold now. And when you want to stop writing bold, you just hit control B again. Or you just hit F4 again. And now it's not bold. Okay, nothing real complicated about that. I mean, personally, I don't like seeing the caret B's there. But you know what you're gonna do. So underlining something is just F3. What? Okay. It did actually type it. It's just really, really faint. It's not showing up at all. I can barely see it.
But it is there.
And it's,
It's just faint. I accidentally hit a button. What happened was there's a function called delete line, which is F5. You hit that and deletes the entire line. Then F2 is your undo button. I did lie when I said you could italicize things because the printers that were in use back then, they were dot matrix or a daisy wheel printer. If you don't know what a daisy wheel printer is, you saw it on my word processing video with my word processor. It types it out really fast. It's like a typewriter, just like a computerized typewriter. And those things did not have italics on them. So if you wanted to have something italicized, you would underline it, and then the publisher would typeset it with italics. So that is actually the italicized, how you italicize on an old, old word processing program like this, and on a typewriter in general. Okay, so we're typing things out. How do we save it? It's pretty simple. It's already saved. So if I hit F10, it'll back us out of there. Then to open that file back up, I just hit D, and we called that Wordstar demo, but it looks like it just called it Wordstar, and we're right back in there. So yeah, that's the basics of Wordstar. It's a word processing program. It's not really anything different. You type and words appear on the screen. As far as would it make Martin slower, I've actually used this program to type an actual chapter from one of my own books, and it was exactly the same as if I would have typed it on any other program. As far as being able to write an entire book on it, if you're comfortable with this, it would be just as quick as any other word processing program. And so in that way, no, there's no way this thing slows down Martin at all. He does use an old computer though, and old computers are prone to breaking, so I could see that maybe slowing him down, but I really don't think that's much of a factor either. I will probably guess that the publisher isn't too thrilled about getting, basically you have to print it out off of this. I doubt he's sending in floppies of this. So they're having to, you know, scan it or type it up the old-fashioned way instead of just being able to load up the file. So that's the only real, you know, drawback, and it doesn't really affect him in the least. Would I recommend giving up Microsoft Word to use this? No. You can if you want to, but this thing, it doesn't communicate. The files are completely incompatible with any modern system. You have to use a fairly expensive translating program. I don't know if there's a free one out there. The only one I found was expensive, but I used a demo version and it purposely put errors in. So when I did that, I had to go through and find the errors and fix it. So that's why I only used it that once, just to see, you know, just for science. I wouldn't recommend using it, but only because we are in the modern age and you're gonna be having to turn your files in digitally for the most part. But yeah, that's Wordstar. And if you like this, I might do another episode on an antiquated program that another famous author uses. So if you'd like to see that, let me know below. And until next time, keep writing.
50 in the numbers of this godforsaken town. It's been a week since all of this went down. In this abandoned factory, there's no one here but you and